Is that for me?
All right, we are back on the power duty. Yes, with that's the kiss for you. There you go.
Thank you very much.
What can I say? This is possibly the flirtiest person I've ever met in my whole life. Whit Crane and Shannon Larkin. How you guys doing?
Very
Ugly
well.
Kid Joe in the studio today. Studio? We don't have a studio. This is the basement. You know, I could get fired possibly for saying that.
The basement?
No, studio.
What?
Oh, it's part of the whole concept here of Much Music. We don't have studios. It's just one big living movie. Did you hear about that yet?
Mm-mm.
No? I'll tell you about it later.
Okay.
Move on to you guys. You have the new album, which is not quite so new anymore, but you brought along a video that we're going to see for the first time here on the Power 30. And this is Menace to Sobriety. There you guys go.
And that's Klaus as a child right there.
Oh, really?
Yeah. That's Klaus in Germany right there.
Yeah, right. Drinking a huge beer.
Mother's milk right there.
And here's a picture of Charlie's Angels on the wall.
Farrah, my first love.
See what I mean?
You can see that I'm at hard at work right there, right?
Yes.
New album.
Yeah.
And then you see those guys this is actually the same, this is this room next door. And you see I'm not really in this picture, but I'm...
But he's hard at work.
I'm meditating.
He's getting inspiration.
Inspiration through the Charlie's Angels.
Menace to Sobriety. Are you guys really Menace to Sobriety?
That's more like a parody. You know, the EP was called As Ugly As They Want to Be, As sure. Nasty As They Want to Be, Two Live Crew, and then and Ice Cube had that album, America's Most Wanted, and we had America's Least Wanted. And then we're thinking of album titles, and basically that... Menace to Society.
And
This is the favorite part. This is Farrell T. Smith. I grew up with Farrell, this guy right here. I grew up with him.
He's very photogenic.
Since we were this big, and we were actually on a Crown Royale binge in San Francisco, California. And I was sitting in his room, looking through his pictures, and that picture right there. Who's looking at it right here? You see that?
Beautiful.
That's Farrell. So he really two F's. He typifies this illustrious title.
Menace to Sobriety.
Thank you very much.
Now, you guys have had a big bout of fame, and how has that left you, let's say?
Educated.
In what sense?
I don't know. We've gotten to travel everywhere in the world. You know, we were lucky enough to break around the globe, so to speak. So we've been able to travel around the world 3 times and go to different cultures and meet different people, you know, good and bad, but concentration mainly on the good people you meet. And,
yeah.
You know, it's cool.
Any regrets, any hopes that things can, you know...
No regrets, because regrets is living in the past. You know, you got to always go towards the future. But more like, you know, we're less... Like, you know, 3 years ago, we were very green. You know, wow, what is this? What are we doing? And
now,
I mean, he's been jamming far longer than I have. He used to be in Souls at Zero, who we're playing with tonight, along with Varga. Souls at Zero Varga.
And, we're gonna play Varga on the show, actually.
You are?
Yep.
They're great. Our manager actually manages those dudes, too. They're great. We're playing them tonight.
We know them very well. Good Canuck boys.
They are. They're really nice guys. They came out to L.A. and we hung out.
Yeah.
But as far as, you know, the future, you know, you got to go into it with a nice big positive lemon twist. You know, it's all good.
Have you been staying out of trouble or getting into more trouble lately?
Staying out of trouble is pretty much the key, you know.
To life itself.
Well, it follows me around, but not as much as it used to.
Why do you think you get into so much trouble, Whit?
I don't know. It's a conspiracy. It's a government conspiracy.
Could it be your ebullient personality and just overall, you know...
I can't believe you got married.
Why?
Where does that leave me? Backdoor man?
Well, listen, you know, when did I interview you the first time?
You had long, straight hair.
That's right. Well, straight. My hair's
And you were the cutest
straight.
Thing on 2 legs.
Yeah, and now I'm just an old married hag,
No, you're
right?
Still the cutest thing on 2 legs. Congratulations on your marriage.
Oh, well, thank you very much.
Though it leaves me kind of sad.
Does it?
Yes.
Well, how do we get into this topic? Am I getting the role? Oh, look, they want us to rap. We'll be back, though. So let's check out your new video, which is new to us, Milkman's son on a Power 30.
And if you look at the very end of the video, you'll see a nice little Aussie inscription on my knuckles.
Aussie,
it's all good.
Aussie rules.
I love you all. We'll be right back.
Yeah.
There's the Aussie knuckle. You guys are huge fans. Of course, we all know that. Aussie, he's a very funny guy.
He rules.
In this CD, you dedicated to Roy Cortez. You just told me the story. Do you want to tell them briefly? Sad but interesting.
Well, when I don't live anywhere right now, but when I finally did get a place to live in Santa Barbara, I moved in this specific place, and Shannon moved right below me. He moved in on the band. Shannon Larkin, the quiet one.
He's not that quiet once the cameras to turn off. Yeah. Growing a beard, right?
Straight to right.
A beard, a month.
$50 $50 would bet him that he couldn't grow a beard. So go on.
Anyway, Roy was this older black guy, dreadlock, really cool guy, married to this lovely woman, Gwen. And we'd come back from touring, you know, we'd go to, we'd go to Brazil, you know, and we'd come back. And he'd go, where were you guys? We were all in Brazil. And he was just amazed that that we traveled so much, you know. And he tripped out on it. I was like, well, maybe one day we'll fly you out and that would be cool. But before that opportunity arose, he got murdered. And he actually got murdered right where we lived, you know, by this prick. And that was devastating for Shannon, myself, a lot of people that knew him, because we hung out a lot, you know. And I've never known anyone that close to die, you know what I'm saying? So
yeah,
I didn't know what to
do. Shocking. So you've dedicated the album to him.
Well, the thing is now he can try, like, even though he's not here physically, spiritually he's here, he's around the world everywhere we ever talked about, you know, that we've been or whatever. So he's traveled vicariously in name through this.
Roy Cortez, good buddy of yours.
He's a good guy, good man.
Well,
God bless him.
Nice thing to do.
Of course. We love Roy.
So you guys are doing, you're touring, of course. You're playing with, one more time?
Souls at Zero. And Varga.
And Varga.
You gotta plug your friend's band.
And they're playing, and you guys are playing tonight?
Yes, we are.
In Toronto?
Do you know where we're playing?
Oh, it's a secret.
Do you know what the name of the place is?
No.
RPM.
Yes. You gotta know where you're playing.
RPM.
I didn't even know where I was when I woke up.
Oh, of course you don't know. I don't blame them. They just go traveling from town to town. September 16th, you're going to be in Winnipeg. On the 17th in Saskatoon. On the 18th in Edmonton. On the 19th in Calgary. And on the 21st, or 22nd, in Vancouver. When you go to Vancouver, say hi to my friend Mary.
All right.
Okay? She's a very nice girl.
Is she married?
No, she's not married. As a matter of fact, look her up. I'll tell you're going to call her. How much time have we got here?
1 second.
All right. Well, we're going to see one of your video picks today.
Okay.
Which is for Jane's Addiction, Stop. Why did you want to see this one?
I love Perry Farrell.
He's rad.
You guys know him very well?
No, I've never met him.
You've never met him?
No, but
I met him once. Hi.
That was it?
There you go.
Okay. You like the band. You like the sound, obviously.
Jane's Addiction rule.
Jane's Addiction rule. Along with Ozzy.
Ozzy's the ruler.
Okay, there you go. Thank you very much for dropping by, guys. We've run out of time.
Thank you, beautiful woman.
You're welcome, Witch and Shannon. And this is Jane's Addiction, Stop. We love it, these guys.
Nosotros tenemos más influencia con sus hijos que tú tienes.